To understand functional components, all of you must have some basic idea about names of cranial nerves, pattern of nerve supply. So initially we will see how the brainstem looks, how it appears, and what is the basic anatomy of the brainstem. This is dorsal view of the brainstem. You can see this is medulla, pons, and this is midbrain. In medulla there is fasciculus gracilis cuneatus. Here these two are cut portions of peduncles, that is cerebellar peduncle. આમાં કેમ નથી આવતું? તારામાં આવી ગયું. ઓકે, સો ધીસ ઇઝ ડોર્સલ વ્યૂ ઓફ ધ બ્રેઇન સ્ટેમ. ધીસ આર ધ સેરેબેલર પેડંકલ્સ. ધીસ ઇઝ મિડ બ્રેઇન. સો ફ્રોમ ક્રેનિયલ ટુ કોડલ ઇટ ઇઝ મિડ બ્રેઇન, પોન્સ એન્ડ મેડ્યુલા ઓબ્લોંગેટા. Our cranial nerves are located from the midbrain side to medulla side, except 1 and 2, olfactory and optic. They are at the base of the forebrain. This is ventral view of the brainstem. So this is midbrain, this is pons, so horizontal fibers. This one is medulla. So in the ventral aspect you can see cranial nerves 3 to 12. There is all 3 to 12 cranial nerves originate from the ventral aspect, except fourth, that is trochlear. It is originating from dorsal aspect. So you can see here in dorsal aspect there is trochlear nerve emerging, and in the ventral aspect it is oculomotor, trigeminal, abducent, facial, vestibulocochlear, glossopharyngeal, vagus, cranial accessory, and hypoglossal. So with this much of knowledge we will go to functional components and its columns. Okay, olfactory and optic nerve, they will originate from the base of the brain stem, base of the forebrain. Remaining 3 to 12 will originate from the brain stem. So this is about developmental aspect. When nervous system develops, it is in the form of neural tube. So here you can see there is one horizontal sulcus. It is known as sulcus limitans, divides a brain neural tube in ventral and dorsal part. This one is ventral part, this one is dorsal part. The ventral is called basal lamina and dorsal part is called alar lamina. So this is from the neural tube two components, one is spinal cord and one is brain. Okay, so here we have represented transverse section of the brain stem. Here it is transverse section of spinal cord. So this is ventral side and this is dorsal side. Here in this diagram both are different. We will modify and edit it whenever there is time. Here, this one is ventral side. This thin sheet is dorsal side. Okay. So, on the ventral side, it is efferent. On the dorsal side, it is afferents. Okay. So, these are the two efferents and these are the two afferents. And nearer to sulcus limitans, near to sulcus limitans, inner sided nuclear column is visceral. Outer sided all four columns is somatic. Again, nearer to sulcus limitans, these four are visceral. Away from sulcus to the periphery, it is somatic. So, these four columns are somatic efferent and visceral efferent. This is visceral efferent and somatic efferent. Okay. So, when there is nothing special, it is called general. When the special components are added, they will be labeled as special. So, initially there are four basic components: general visceral efferent, general somatic efferent, general visceral afferent, and general somatic afferent. I strongly recommend all of you to speak up all these names, discuss all these names. If you have nobody around you, you can go to your mirror and see yourself how you look, because in the viva you have to speak all these things. You have to write in the theory exams also. So it is strongly recommended to speak all seven names. In cranial nerves also, in the beginning they will describe these components. It is very essential and fundamentally important to understand them and to speak up and draw as much as possible. So I hope you are repeating after me, because we are in lecture. So even if you are sitting in your room, you can speak up, because all of you are muted. Okay, so I hope you will speak with me. So general visceral efferent, general somatic efferent, general visceral afferent, and general somatic afferent. So these are the four basic functional components or nuclear column. Remember definition of nuclei: it is collection of cell body of neuron within CNS. So this is basically a collection of cell body of neurons which are developing. And when there will be axons coming out through these nuclei, they will be labeled as nerves. So here, this is ventral side, this is dorsal side. So imagine that from the dorsal side, if you cut this part, if you split this part, so that it will open up bilaterally on right and left sides. Okay. So if you cut, if you just cut this here, it will open like a book. Okay. So this is dorsal side. Here we are cutting dorsal lamina, so it is opening up like book. So it is connected by sheet of white matter here. Okay. So this gap here, a little gap, represents sulcus limitans. Here also there is sulcus limitans. So around sulcus limitans, these are the visceral columns. Here red color represents special, remaining all are general. Okay, so red color will be appearing later on. So nearer sulcus limitans, we have general visceral efferent and general visceral afferent. Away from sulcus, this is general somatic efferent and general somatic afferent. Okay, now in the later part of development, these two special columns are added in between these two and in between these two. So one red dot between here, these two, and one red dot between these two. So you will remove general word and you will add special word. So it will be known as instead of general visceral efferent, you remove G and you add S. It is special visceral efferent. Similarly here, general visceral afferent, you remove general and you add special. It is called special visceral afferent. So we have added two special in between two general. General visceral efferent, special visceral afferent. And in the third last stage, when 3 plus 3 is over, at the most lateral part, most special nucleus appear. On the most lateral, most distal part, it is called special somatic afferent. It is very much special, and you all of know, all of you will know how it is special. It will represent your vestibulo cochlear nerve. That is very much special. It is added at the most lateral part. So repeat, from medial to lateral side, this is median sulcus, this is sulcus limitans. So from median sulcus to most lateral side, general somatic efferent, special visceral efferent, general visceral efferent, general visceral afferent, special visceral afferent, general somatic afferent, and special somatic afferent. This of all of you must remember this scheme because it will be referred many times. So these seven functional columns are of three types: sensory, motor, and mix. Okay, so these columns are specific, okay, but these three types, sensory, motor, and mix, these types are applicable to nerves. That is your cranial nerves, nerves which will come from or originate from these columns. These columns are themselves divided in seven groups typically, but the axons which will come out through these columns, they will form cranial nerves. The nerves can be sensory, motor, or mixed. That means one nerve, any one cranial nerve can contain axons or fibers from many columns and vice versa. One nuclear column can contribute to many cranial nerves. Again, one cranial nerve can contain fibers of many nuclei, and one nuclei can contribute fibers to many cranial nerves, and one cranial nerve can have fibers from more than one nucleus. Okay, and the fibers which are above this nuclear column, that is above brain stem, that is called corticonuclear fibers. From the cerebral cortex to nuclei of cranial nerves is corticonuclear fibers. So whenever we speak of supranuclear or infranuclear, that means above this nuclear column, that is from the cerebral cortex, and below this nuclei, that is at the peripheral nerve level. And when there is only nuclear word, it is this column or nuclei itself. The three different levels: supranuclear, nuclear, and infranuclear levels. Now, this is all breakup of all seven columns. Columns of basal lamina, that is efferent. Columns of alar lamina, that is afferent. And 3 plus 3 plus 1. Now, when the neural tube develops, there is elongation of nuclear column. But some of the nuclear column will become smaller. They will integrate, they will become shorter. Some will migrate deeper into the brainstem, and some will remain in the form of column only. So in the main diagram, we will see which nuclei appears as a column, which are remaining discrete or smaller. So first of all, we are describing this diagram in the form of table. This table is very important to remember. This table represents only right side. So imagine yourself here, sulcus limitans. Sorry, this is a median sulcus, and here there is sulcus limitans. I will show you in the diagram first. This is whole of the transverse section of brainstem. Here it is median sulcus. Here it is sulcus limitans. Here also sulcus limitans of left side, of right side. So from this table we are going to see it is of right side. Only this much part of neural tube we are going to represent in the table. You imagine yourself left side. This is right side of nuclear columns. Here there is median sulcus, and here there is sulcus limitans. So between these are three. Lateral to sulcus limitans, it is again three, plus one, it is most lateral side. So three plus three plus one. Okay. Now in this table we will see simpler things first. So what is most simple? This large part, this is full column of nucleus that represents your trigeminal nucleus. So this elongated column extending in all three levels, midbrain, pons and medulla, all three levels extending, this column is your trigeminal nucleus. So trigeminal nucleus is divided in two main parts, motor and sensory. So here you can imagine motor nucleus, and sensory is divided in three parts. It is mesencephalic nucleus, main sensory nucleus and spinal nucleus. Okay. So three parts of the sensory component: mesencephalic, main sensory or chief sensory, and spinal nucleus. The motor part is motor nucleus. It is not shown here. Then one more easy thing: special somatic afferent, most lateral, most distal. It is your vestibulocochlear nerve. It is eighth cranial nerve. You know the two divisions, vestibular nerve and cochlear nerve. So vestibular nerve is represented in four different parts of vestibular nuclei. Cochlear nerve is represented in two different parts of cochlear nuclei. Names of these nuclei: superior, inferior, medial and lateral vestibular nucleus, ventral and dorsal cochlear nucleus. If you sum up these directions, it is total six. See this, all six directions are covered here: superior, inferior, medial, lateral, ventral, dorsal. So in ventral and dorsal it is cochlear nucleus, and remaining four it is vestibular nucleus. So this is your special somatic afferent nucleus. So these two are simple and easy to place in the table and diagram as well. So general somatic afferent and special somatic afferent, we have covered these two. See these two: special somatic afferent and general somatic afferent. Here you have trigeminal nucleus, and here you have vestibular and cochlear nucleus. Now remaining parts are little bit complicated. We'll try to make them simpler. Seven, nine, and 10. These three groups, nerves or nuclei of 7, 9, and 10. It is repeated in the groups. How? You can see here. These two are 7. This is 9. This is 10. Here they are together. 7, 9, 10. So 7, 9, and 10, they are together in the single column. So here these two components are represented together: general visceral afferent and special visceral afferent. They are anatomically merged, or in the single column they are appearing together. Okay, so that is your nucleus of tractus solitarius, also known as nucleus of solitary tract. Now how to remember this? NTS, it is short form, nucleus tractus solitarius. Okay, two things you can observe: NTS, that is 9, 10 and 7 cranial nerve, 9, 10 and 7, that is NTS, 9, 10 and 7. So these three nerves will have test fibers related to this nucleus. So test is a type of spatial sensation. So spatial visceral afferent component of the test, it is represented here in NTS nucleus. If you remember, nerve supply of tongue, it is divided in three, that is ventral 2/3, dorsal 1/3 and posterior most part. Okay, so anterior 2/3 is supplied by 7th nerve, posterior 1/3 is supplied by 9th. So and most posterior part is supplied by 10th nerve. It is 7, 9, 10. Ventral 2/3 of tongue by 7th nerve. Posterior 1/3 of tongue supplied by 9th nerve. And most posterior part supplied by 10th nerve. Remember, corda tympani and lingual nerve, glossopharyngeal nerve, and internal laryngeal branch of vagus nerve. So these three nerves supply together to the taste fibers or papilla of the tongue. Okay, so this taste is specially represented in nucleus tractus solitarius. It is basically a column of U shape. Both sided nucleus tractus solitarius will merge from the lower side. We will learn in next lecture of nuclei. Again, 7, 9, 10 here. General visceral efferent. Okay, so here 7, 2 nuclei in the 7th nerve, here 1 nucleus of 9th nerve, and here this whole large one of the 10th nerve. So it is called superior salivatory and lacrimatory nucleus. 7th nerve is having 2 nuclei here, superior salivatory and lacrimatory. 9th nerve, inferior salivatory nucleus, and 10th nerve, that is dorsal nucleus of vagus. So we have completed 7 9 10, 7 9 10 triplet in GVA and SVA column together, that is representing NTS nucleus. And here 7 9 in the pons, superior salivatory and lacrimatory from the 7th nerve, and inferior salivatory from the 9th nerve. And 10th nerve, it is representing dorsal nucleus of vagus. Now, one more large nucleus, it is nucleus ambiguus. you have to catch pronunciation from here. N nucleus ambiguus, that is N means 9th, A means 11th. Okay, so 9th, 10th and 11th, now they are represented in nucleus ambiguus. 9, 10, 11. Now remaining nuclei, one more large, it is hypoglossal in the general somatic efferent. Okay. You remember oculomotor nucleus complex in the oculomotor nerve lecture. So it is a large nucleus which is supplying many muscles of extraocular muscles. Okay, except superior, oblique and lateral rectus. So you remember that 3, 4, 6 complex. Okay, 3, 4, 6 you remember together. 3, 4, 6. 3, 4 in the midbrain and 6 in the pons. So these 3, 4, and 6 represents your extraocular muscles of eyeball. So 3 means superior rectus, inferior rectus, medial rectus, and then inferior oblique and levator palpebrae superioris. These are covered by oculomotor nucleus major part. Okay, fourth now trochlear nerve will cover superior oblique muscle. Sixth nerve will supply lateral rectus muscle. So these 3, 4, 6 you divide yourself in extraocular muscles. 3, 4 in the midbrain and 6 in the pons. In the third nerve, one nucleus is detached. It is part of third nerve, but it is represented in general visceral efferent. That is your Edinger-Westphal nucleus. Remember, this is a parasympathetic component. It is supplying this sphincter pupillae and ciliary muscles, responsible for light reflex and accommodation reflex. And the sympathetic fibers that will come from superior cervical ganglion, and they will travel via arteries, branches around sympathetic plexus. So we remember motor nucleus of trigeminal nerve. It is not represented here, so it is here 5, 7. This is motor nucleus of this trigeminal nerve. It is separated here in special visceral efferent column. So I hope all of you have got idea of this table. We will quickly revise this table. This is transverse section of neural tube. This is median sulcus. We are observing this right half of these columns. This is median sulcus and this is sulcus limitans. This 3 plus 4 nuclei. Here median sulcus, here sulcus limitans, medial to sulcus limitans these 3, lateral to sulcus limitans these 4 components. Okay, initially we will draw these 3 plus 4 tables, then we will draw these horizontal midbrain, pons and medulla, then we will start dividing nuclei. Okay, first we will draw larger trigeminal, mesencephalic, main sensory and spinal nucleus of trigeminal. Then we will draw special somatic afferent. This is larger vestibular nucleus and these 2 are cochlear nuclei. All 6 directions you write by yourself. Then we will go to 7, 9, 10 triplet. It is 2 times here only in the medulla, all 7, 9, 10. That is your NTS, nucleus tractus solitarius, 9, 10 and 7th now. Again you divide 7, 9, 10, but you detach this 10th now nucleus in the medulla only, and you divide again 7 and 9 in the pons. 7 is superior salivatory and lacrimatory, 9th is inferior salivatory nucleus, and 10th is your dorsal nucleus of vagus. 7, 9, 10 together here and 7, 9, 10 separated here. Okay. Now, nucleus ambiguous, that is 9, 10, 11. N for 9, A for 11, that is 9th, 10th and 11th now. Then hypoglossal nucleus in the general somatic efferent. Then we will remember extraocular muscles of eyeball, that is 3, 4, 6th now. Oculomotor nuclear complex, trochlear now and abducens now. Okay, and after everything is over, we will put these two motor nuclei. See, these two motor nuclei are detached from the facial and trigeminal. So you remember, in the trigeminal and facial, there is separate motor nuclei that you have to put here. Special visceral efferent. This is also known as branchiomotor or pharyngeomotor nuclear column that will supply head and neck muscles. So with this much, your functional component is over. Now you should correlate this table in your textbook, Neuroanatomy. This table, see here, olfactory and optic now, it is separated, it is not described in the brainstem. This is your oculomotor nucleus. Trochlear 3, 4 and 6. This is your 6th now. Then 5. This is your 5. Mesencephalic, main sensory and spinal nucleus. It is in the one single column and motor nucleus in another column. And then 8th, that is special somatic afferent. 4 vestibular nuclei and 2 cochlear nuclei. This whole represents vestibulocochlear special somatic afferent. Then we have 7, 9, 10. This is your 9th cranial nerve. It is having contribution from NTS and NTS, two different columns. Okay, one of the component of glossopharyngeal will also be in the ambiguous, nucleus ambiguous, that is 9, 10 and 11. Okay, so your glossopharyngeal now is represented in three different columns. And this 12th nucleus, hypoglossal nucleus, is a separate one. Here, separate column. 11th now, two different parts, cranial accessory and spinal accessory. Cranial accessory will be together along with spinal nucleus of trigeminal, and spinal accessory will be separate in nucleus ambiguous. 10th now is again all different parts, you can see in the table by yourself. And then 3, 4, 6, oculomotor, trochlear and abducens is level is described in the table, you can correlate from the table here. See, I recommend all of you to go sequence by sequence. First you should have basic idea about external features of brainstem. Then you go through this table, neural tube, 4 columns. Then you make yourself 7 columns. Then you draw that table. And then you draw that diagram and understand yourself. Then after everything you go through, you just come here to see this table. And this, after you understand nerve and its component, then you should see this tissue. Which particular tissue they are innervating and why they are called general or special. One more diagram to make it easy. This is your neural tube. You can see this is median sulcus. This is right half. This is left half. And we have prepared this right half table. So you, I am keeping these slides for 2-3 minutes. You can see by yourself the components given in the table. This is median sulcus. Somewhere here you have sulcus limitans. Here you have 3 columns. And lateral to sulcus you have 4 columns. This 3 column is general somatic efferent, special visceral efferent and general visceral efferent. Here 3, 4, 6 now. For eyeball, this is 12th. There is 5, 7 in the bones. And 7 is having 2 parts, superior salivatory and lacrimatory, and inferior salivatory, 2 parts of this 7th nerve. This inferior salivatory will go to the 9th nerve. That is 9, 10 and 11, special visceral efferent. So 5, 7 and 9, 10, 11. You can detach part of 9th nerve and join with inferior salivatory. Then there is this dorsal nucleus of vagus, that is 10th nerve, general visceral efferent. Here you can detach Edinger Westphal from the 3rd nerve. Then lateral to sulcus limitans, this nucleus tractus solitarius, that is 9, 10 and 7th nerve for taste sensation. 2 columns together, general and special visceral afferent. Then you have this spinal nucleus in 3 parts, mesencephalic, main sensory and spinal nucleus. Your motor nucleus is separated from here to this part. Then you have special somatic afferent dividing into vestibular nuclei and cochlear nuclei. 2-4 parts of vestibular, superior, inferior, medial, lateral. 2 parts of cochlear, that is ventral and dorsal cochlear nucleus. So this lecture is over. I hope all of you will have lot of queries. It is very, very tough topic. It is described in your IB Singh and Vishram Singh textbooks. I have shared PDF with you in the group. I have combined the contents and diagrams into one separate lecture note. You can see that note and learn by yourself. Thank you. If you have any query, you can raise in the chat box.